Appian web APIs can only be called by an authenticated Appian user or a service account. In other words, an external system must identify itself to Appian before it can call a web API. External systems can be authenticated using basic authentication, API key authentication, and OAuth 2.0 client credentials grants. To show you the basic authentication method, I'm going to use a desktop application called Postman and the command line utility curl. Basic authentication is using your Appian username and password. This is the default authentication method for your web APIs if a user logs in with Appian or LDAP authentication. If we send a request to the Hello World web API, it returns an error because authentication failed. This makes sense because we didn't add any credentials to the request. To use basic authentication, you need to add a username and password with permissions to call the web API. The credentials can be sent with the request to the web API. Basic authentication cannot be used by members of SAML or service account system groups. API key authentication has several advantages over basic authentication. First is security. API keys are randomly generated and cannot be used to log into Appian. Second is performance. API keys are up to 10 times faster than using a username and password. Finally, longevity. API keys don't expire automatically, so you can maintain the same credentials in external systems that call Appian web APIs. When you create an API key, you tie it to a service account, which is similar to a user, but you cannot use it to log into Appian. To invoke a web API using an API key, the service account needs to have access to the web API. This is completed with group management. OAuth 2.0 Client Credentials Grant is another way to invoke web APIs and is an industry standard protocol for authorization. Like an API key, each OAuth 2.0 client is tied to a service account. That service account must also be granted access to the web API using group management. An OAuth 2.0 client can use the same service account as an API key, so you can easily update from using an API key to using an OAuth 2.0 client credentials grant.